The real truth about electric cars, no one is telling you. Electric vehicles have been in the news for over a decade now, but most people don't seem to understand anything about them except the fact that they are cleaner ways to move around. Major brands like Tesla and Rivian have taken the car industry by storm, and now traditional car makers like BMW, Ford, Nissan, and Kia are looking for a share of the EV market. So, before you jump into buying an electric vehicle, here is the real truth about almost every electric car on our roads. All electric vehicles, also known as battery electric vehicles, are powered by an electric motor rather than an internal combustion engine. The electric motor is powered by a large traction battery pack, which must be plugged into a wall outlet or charging equipment, also known as electric vehicle supply equipment. Because it is powered by electricity, there's no exhaust from the tailpipe, and no typical liquid fuel components such as a fuel pump, fuel line, or fuel tank are present. Electricity versus fossil fuel is presented as one of the most significant discussions surrounding the relevance of EVs. European electric vehicles produce CO2 emissions approximately 3 times lower than gasoline or diesel-powered vehicles. This is because electricity-producing batteries power electric cars instead of internal combustion engines. Several studies, such as the one conducted by David Reichmuth, senior engineer at the Clean Transportation Program, back this fact. According to Reichmuth's findings, using gasoline to power a vehicle emits much more than using electricity. Renewable energy sources, such as wind and solar, are increasingly being incorporated into the electrical networks of many European countries. These renewable energy sources contribute an average of 50% of the total energy used in countries such as Sweden, Finland, and Latvia. For the first time ever, more electricity was generated in the EU by wind and solar than by coal in 2019. Emissions caused by charging electric vehicles are decreasing, and this trend will continue as more coal plants are replaced with cleaner power sources. And talking about power, if you stick around long enough, I will share some tips on avoiding the range anxiety that comes with the fear of losing power mid-journey when using an EV. Meanwhile, electric vehicles may be responsible for higher CO2 and SO2 pollution levels in certain regions where coal plants provide most of the power. During the manufacturing process, electric cars also produce certain emissions, primarily tied to the creation of their batteries. However, according to some estimates, it will take less than 2 years of driving for certain EV models to save more carbon than it took to produce the vehicles. But the question remains, are EVs truly the perfect solution they are presented to be? More on some dark parts of these electric cars as we go along. And while we're at it, this is a perfect time to subscribe to Future EV so you never miss out on exciting and informative content on everything EV. Subscribe today and hit the notification bell for firsthand access anytime we upload a new video. And so, to put things in perspective, electric vehicles basically skip the emission of harmful gases such as carbon monoxide, which gasoline or diesel cars produce. More so, the absence of a fossil fuel-powered engine also means that electric vehicles run much more silently, which helps to reduce the amount of noise pollution we usually find around us. While on the subject of advantages, do EV prices also come across as an advantage or a turnoff? According to responses from a recent poll, over 90% of people who own electric cars said they have no plans to switch to gasoline or diesel-powered automobiles in the foreseeable future. Why would they? Apart from the cost of the vehicle itself, the maintenance costs of electric cars are far cheaper than traditional vehicles. After all, you can't compare the maintenance cost of a 2,000-part internal combustion engine with that of, say, a 20-part drive crane in an EV. That is not to erase the fact that there aren't some costs to be incurred when using an electric vehicle. The battery that powers an EV is the most expensive part of the entire vehicle and can last about 10 years before it needs to be replaced. As we go along, you will come across more information on the life cycle of the battery and how to maintain it. Because of incentives such as the federal EV tax credit, the price of many electric vehicles is comparable to or even lower than the price of the typical new vehicle. As a result, people in the United States from all income levels are becoming increasingly interested in EVs. According to current research findings, the production cost of electric cars and trucks will be lower than that of gasoline and diesel vehicles in Europe by the year 2027, at the very latest. This cost reduction is mainly due to decreasing EV battery prices and automobile manufacturers' development of production lines for electric vehicles. In addition to the tax credits offered at the federal level, many states also offer their own form of these tax credits. In addition, the typical driver of an electric vehicle will save between $750 and $1,600 per year on fuel costs. And did you know that in most parts of Europe, electric cars do not have to pay any form of registration tax? This happens in countries such as Belgium, Greece, Hungary, the Netherlands, Latvia, and Portugal. Furthermore, certain nations, including Norway, Germany, France, Italy, Spain, and Sweden, provide free parking for electric vehicles in their respective cities. The cost of the batteries has decreased dramatically over the past 10 years, by an 89% margin since 2010 alone. Is it any surprise that the global sales of electric vehicles increased by 43% in 2020? If this development is something that excites you, do go ahead and hit that like button. When it comes to maintaining the battery to avoid high maintenance costs, as mentioned in the previous point, you will need to understand some truths about EV batteries. Extreme hot and cold temperatures are simply bad news for EV batteries. In an interview with ABC News, the Vice President of Industry Analysis at Auto Pacific, Ed Kim, said, "Lithium-ion batteries are subject to temperature sensitivity. In polar vortex conditions, these vehicles wouldn't get far. Furthermore, you could also damage it if you let it die off entirely or overcharge it often. Paying attention to some of these crucial tips can help you maintain the integrity of your EV battery, especially when you consider that they lose about 2.3% of their original capacity range every year. One of the best ways to maintain your EV battery is to ensure it is constantly within the 20% and 80% charge range. Most people in the US travel less than 40 kilometers per day, a distance significantly less than the range of 200 to 490 kilometers attainable with today's electric cars. It is best to let it charge all the way up to 100% if you're thinking about going on a long trip. There's no need to be afraid of your car running out of juice along the way when traveling long distances. This is a significant fear for most consumers and is usually called range anxiety. Gonzalo Bronco, director of Smart Mobility, said, "Range anxiety, the fear that your battery will run out, is more perceived by those who are still considering buying an electric vehicle than actual electric vehicle users. You don't have to leave your electric car at home or fall victim to this fear because the network of public chargers is expanding rapidly. The number of EV charging stations in the United States has skyrocketed from 430 in 2008 to over 68,800 in 2019. Moreover, there were over 200,000 public charging outlets across the EU by the end of the year 2020, and that number is still growing, and they are not ending there. The EU is working on installing 3 million of them by the year 2030. These charging stations can be easily located through the European Alternative Fuel Observatory's charging point map and other maps such as Open Charge and PlugShare. The first battery that gave a 320-kilometer charge in 5 minutes was manufactured in early 2021. This comes as a manifestation of the statement by Ed Kim in 2019, where he said, "Faster charging will get us closer to the level of convenience with gasoline cars." Today, EV owners can charge their electric cars in nearly the same amount of time as it takes to fill up full gasoline or diesel tanks. The maintenance and durability of EV batteries, however, are maybe one of the least of their downsides. There are currently major concerns concerning mining these lithium-ion batteries and the damage they cause in the process. A case in point of this situation is the reduction of fresh water in the Atacama Desert in Chile, where large amounts of lithium are mined. As the demand for lithium continues to expand, critics are beginning to wonder the level of damage humanity stands to deal with from its aftermath. So, there you have it, folks. Do you know any controversies about EVs that you'd like to share? Let's head over to the comments section and get talking. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.